Get ready to match the stars. Dick Martin. Brett Summers. Charles Nelson Reilly. Elaine Joyce. Richard Dawson. And Fanny Fly. As we play the star-studded big money match game 78. And now, here's the star of match game 78.
Everybody okay out there? Because everybody's okay up here.
We're okay.
You're a dandy bunch. Yes, sometimes have a little difficulty there. Are you all right?
Yeah. Oh!
There was a piece of cigarette ash or something there, and I just want you to look neat when you're on camera.
Dirty.
That's
old
all
man.
Applaud. Jeannie Weiss. Keep it your hair up. Jeannie is a current champ. She's won $950. She just won her second game as time expired last time. And she's going to be playing for $2,500. You ready for that?
Yes.
Okay, we'll be ready for you in 1 minute and 4 3/10 seconds. Okay, Jeannie Weiss has won the $250. That means she's playing for $2,500. And in order to collect that amount of money, Jeannie, you have to match one celebrity. It has to be an exact match. You have to choose one now.
Richard.
Okay, Richard, here we go. This one is worth $2,500, and it reads as follows. Times blank. That's T-I-M-E apostrophe S blank. Times blank. Times blank. Times blank. I gather from the amount of time Richard took that this is a hard one.
Yes.
Is it hard for you?
Yes. I'm at a blank.
You at a blank?
Mm-hmm.
Well, now look at it. We'll give you a few more seconds before the buzzer sounds. Times blank.
Past.
Times past. All right. She says times past will match you for the $2,500. Richard, what do you say?
No, I said times are wasting.
Times are wasting. What's that?
Hard.
Now, wait a minute. Times Square is not spelled T-I-M-E apostrophe S.
Ha, ha, ha!
Times of flying was the only thing I could think of.
Time, yeah.
What's that? What's that?
Time's
up.
Yeah.
Oh,
that's a very good one.
Time is up.
All right.
Up.
Jeannie, time you have a total of $950. You're going to meet another player, so let's welcome Mike Mazzaro.
Hello. Yes.
Right. We welcome you, sir, and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself, if you would.
I will. My wife and I are from a very pretty community on the western slope of the Rockies, Durango, Colorado.
Oh, yes.
I just finished up a master's degree not too long ago. We're out here in California visiting relatives while I try to decide whether to go on for a doctorate or do what I would really like to do, which is write for a living.
What is your field of study?
Theater.
Theater.
Dramatic literature. And my wife very kindly gave me a note so that I could confess unashamedly that I've been in love with Fanny Flagg forever.
Ah, well. Oh,
nice.
Oh, she's all set for tonight.
Yeah.
That's one down.
Is your wife here?
Yes, I don't know if she's in the audience watching because she said she didn't know if her heart would stand the strain.
I see. Well, we'll try and bear up under it, won't we, Fanny?
Yes.
Thank you. Good luck to you, Mike. Here we go. You have a choice of A or B.
B, please.
B it is. The Hollywood dentist said, "What a day. I'm exhausted. Today, blank came in for a teeth cleaning." The Hollywood dentist is speaking. What a day. I'm exhausted.
Don't you expect a house to come down?
It's a terrible question.
No, it's a very good question. It's an excellent question. Now, think about it for a second. The Hollywood dentist said, "I'm exhausted. What a day. Today, blank came in for a teeth cleaning."
Oh.
Very good. Okay. Mike, the Hollywood dentist said, what a day. I'm exhausted. Today, Blank came in for a teeth cleaning.
The most exhausting I can think of is King Kong.
King Kong. He said King Kong.
A very good answer.
That's one of the good ones.
However.
Yes.
I was thinking more in terms of cartoons. I said Dumbo.
Dumbo, the elephant.
Yeah. I've lost them again.
Yes, you have. They're a very fickle bunch.
I'll get them back.
Okay.
Those people have never been known for their loyalty.
No, that's true.
Anyway, you remember I said about this question? It's a terrific question. King Kong.
King Kong. Okay.
I've got the most ridiculous envelope here that has the most ridiculous answer of the season.
It has.
Oh, Dumbo the elephant.
Lassie. Lassie, that would be
difficult. Get the camera off me on all counts. Off.
Elaine?
Hello.
Hollywood dentist said, what a day, I'm exhausted today. Blank came in for a teeth cleaning.
Jaws.
Jaws.
I knew they'd like that. Jaws 1 and 2.
However, Mike is looking for the answer, King Kong. You offer a King Kong, Richard.
No, I offer a Liberace.
Well, what we're after is anybody with a lot of teeth, right?
Right. I'm sorry, Mike. I thought of Farrah Fawcett.
Yeah. That would take 3 weeks to clean her teeth alone. Okay, so there we are at the end of round, at the middle of round one, and you've picked up one, and that's not a bad start, and yours will be long in a moment. Right now, we've got this for you. Pay attention. Here we go. The other half of round one. Jeannie, this is your question. On the airplane, Stephanie said, I don't have much confidence in this airline. I just saw the pilot and he had a blank sticking out of his pocket. I don't have much confidence in this airline. I just saw the pilot and he had a blank sticking out of his pocket.
Pockets is plural?
Pocket, singular.
Oh.
It's just if he had a blank sticking out of his pocket.
It's not Hamlet or anything like that, you see. A simple answer is all we request.
You're always strange when you wear that green suit.
Is that suit green?
Yeah.
Oh.
Perfect.
Okay, Jeannie. On the airplane, Stephanie said, I don't have much confidence in this airline. I just saw the pilot, and he had a blank sticking out of his pocket.
A gun?
A gun? Why would that not give her confidence in the airline? I don't understand that answer. Do you?
No, I think that if he had a gun, it would be for his safety.
Yes.
But I would feel... I would feel put upon if he had a screwdriver sticking out of his pocket.
A screwdriver?
Yeah.
It means something's falling apart in the airplane there. Oh, boy. What do you got here?
I said that he had a wrench sticking out of his pocket.
A wrench, screwdriver, tools.
Why do you think that's swelling this thing?
They're weird, that's all. What have you got?
They feel bad about booing him before.
That's right.
Oh, yeah, they're making up to him now.
I'll get the timing. I can hear it spilling over from the other one, and then you have your remark. I can get the timing. And a one and a turn.
Boy, yes.
No, I said a bottle of Overholt Rye.
Overholt Rye. Bottle of booze, he said. That'd make you nervous if you saw the pilot with a bottle of booze sticking out of his pocket. What do you say?
I said a flask.
A flask. Same thing. All right. We come to you, sir.
Prayer book.
A prayer book. Right. I would be very nervous. How about you, Fanny?
Well, I would be extremely nervous if he had a parachute.
A parachute.
Sticking out of his pocket.
And he didn't pass them out to the other passengers. That would make me nervous, too. Bing, here we go to round two. Mike, A or B?
B, please.
B it is. One person does not play. That's you, Brett. Gloria said, my husband's very peculiar. For our ivory wedding anniversary, he gave me a blank. My husband's very peculiar for our...
How many years do you have to be married for an ivory wedding?
I don't know. What year is ivory?
What year is
ivory? Ivory must be like the 10th, I would say.
Five?
What is it?
No. You're crazy.
Five is paper.
Five?
Five is tin.
Five? Five is tin? Iris says five is ivory.
Ira, no.
Now that we got all that settled, what the heck is the question?
You must pay attention.
I paid attention. Gloria, don't... All right. Gotcha.
Okay. Here it is, Mike. Gloria said, my husband's very peculiar. For our ivory wedding anniversary, he gave me a blank.
An elephant tusk.
Naturally. And don't know him, that happens to be an excellent answer. Right?
I like it.
Well, I've already given elephants, so I can't give two elephants in one game.
Oh, you can't.
So I said a piano.
A piano would be good, yeah.
I love a piano.
I haven't gotten them yet.
I have the envelope here for the most weird answer of the season. Piano.
No, those are ivories. They call them ivories. And
it's one just time this whole period of my life is uphill. An elephant.
An elephant.
Well.
Not an elephant tusk.
Well, no, he specifically said an elephant tusk, and we can't match that with an elephant.
Oh.
Even though the tusk is part of the elephant. The people are revolting. I've thought so as soon as I saw him.
I don't often get straight lines like that.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Go.
I said an elephant too. Come on, let's book!
I have pachyderm, nothing to do with the decision.
A pachyderm, no?
Pachyderm.
No?
All right, Richard, show us your tusk.
Elephant.
Elephant. All right, Fanny, get mad.
You can't do Michael this way. Who do you think you are?
Oh, it's Mark Goodson.
Okay. So, Jeannie, again, you're in the catbird seat. You need one to tie, two to win. Norman, the nice guy, is the nicest exterminator in the world. He's the only exterminator that kills bugs with blank. There you go.
Norman the nice guy is the nicest exterminator in the world. He's the only... Do I have to play?
Yes, you have to play. You're in this.
Okay. I thought I just...
He's finished. Finished. Everybody finished down here. Not quite. There it is.
Kills bugs with.
Okay, Brett, put it in the slot.
Okay, honey.
There we go. Norman the nice guy is the nicest exterminator in the world. He's the only exterminator that kills bugs with blank.
With love.
With love. He kills bugs with love. What do you say to that?
I said elephant.
I see.
I said with love.
Love. Score is tied 1-1.
This may come as a shock to you. I said love.
Love wins the game. All the rest of you have. Many gifts will be coming your way for Match Game 78. Thank you for
being
here.
I had a great time.
Good luck. Mike Mazzaro, so now we're spinning them off. We're going to spin a message or two just for you.
Today's consolation prizes are first, Billy the Kid fashion coordinates for boys of all ages, from toddlers to teens, available in all leading stores throughout the USA. And jewelry from Sarah Coventry, who has jewelry with fashion know-how for every occasion. Versatile, fashionable Sarah Coventry jewelry sold at home fashion shows. And 8 tickets to Universal's funny love story, House Call, where Barb Witt and tender embraces alternate wildly between divorcee Glenda Jackson and Walter Matthau, rated PG. And a set of bath towels and a supply of Stay Puft Pink fabric softener to leave your washable softer and fresh and towels more absorbent. Stay Puft Pink for soft, absorbent washables. More of those funny matches coming up with Jeannie Rayburn.
Thank you, Johnny O, and here we go one more time with Jeannie White. She has a total of $1,050. This is her third shot at it now, and she's going to try and win the $5,000 one more time. Not too long ago, we polled a studio audience. We said, write down your best answer to this. Blank K. Now, if you give us the answer that they wrote down most frequently, remember, we give you $500. We give you $250 for matching their second most popular response and $100 for matching the third. And three of our six celebrities will give you an assist here.
Brett.
Okay.
Okay.
Dick.
Beatrice K.
Beatrice K.
Beatrice K, a big star.
Dick.
You
well,
mean
it's spelled
Richard.
Differently, but I'll say Danny K.
Danny K.
Because you
yeah,
know
he says an E on his, doesn't
yeah,
he?
Yeah, but our audience is... That's yeah. never stopped
Sammy
them.
With Sammy K.
All right. Now, Danny K, OK, and Beatrice K are the three they've suggested. You have the option at this time of choosing one of those or giving
okay.
us one of your own. What is your pleasure?
I'm going to go with Danny K.
All right. I went with Danny K once, but that was a long time ago in another story, in another life, in another incarnation. We're looking for Danny K. May we see the $100 response, please? Okay is an answer that Brett gave us, right? Not bad. May we see the $250 number? Mary K.
Mary K. True.
Cosmetics.
I think, yeah, I know, but it looks very good for you here now. I think I would bet a nickel at this point that Danny Kay's going to come up there.
Don't throw your
money. All right, we're looking for Danny Kay. Slide it, please. Yeah! Very good, Dick. Very good. Well, that was very well done.
Very well done.
So you got the $500, play for 10 times that amount or $5,000, and you know you have to match one to get it.
Okay, Richard, this is it.
This is it.
I want it to be, Donald.
All right. Ready? Good luck. Here it is. Easy as blank. Easy as blank. Think hard. And give us your best shot now. Easy as...
Pie.
Pie. Okay, Richard. She says, easy as pie, we'll match you for the $5,000. What do you say to that?
I'm sorry, in England we say cake, not pie.
It's not easy as cake. You English are so different.
Oh, stick it in your pie.
Together here while we introduce our new player. Let's all welcome Pat Sawyer. Hello, Pat
Hi.
Sawyer.
Hi.
She's very excited.
Oh, I know.
We'll give her a chance to cool down a little bit while we talk to you and find out where you're from and all that.
Well, I'm from Chicago originally, but
yeah.
I live in...
Aren't we all?
I live here now, though.
Yes.
And I'm married... And about a little over 3 years ago, I came to watch the match game being filmed. And I was very pregnant, and it made the pages real nervous. So they marched me up the back stairs, and I talked to you. And you said, I hope you name your child after me. And I said, oh, I will, definitely. So it was a girl, and I called her Star.
Oh!
Hi, thank you for
that.
That's a lovely story, my dear. Yeah. How is Star doing?
She's just fine.
And how old is she now?
Three.
She's three?
Yeah.
3 years old?
Three.
Time for seems like yesterday.
Yeah.
You know, you could have called her Eugenia. Okay. Say hello to Star when you see her, will you? We don't have time to do another question here. We have to do a little business with America. But I want you to both sit tight and everybody pay attention to what's going on. He got caught on camera, I saw him. You rascal. That was Iris Gutch, that fleeting body you saw hurtling through space there a moment ago. Zorro lives again. It's alive, that thing.
Mule train!
Clippity-clop, clippity-clop.
Listen, We have to put you in cold storage until next time because we can't do another questionnaire. We just got a little time to fool around. Anybody want
to
fool around?
They're not allowed to go into their families
now,
or anything,
Now, you do
right?
know that I'm opening at Backstage, Ted Hook's Backstage, West 45th Street. I'm singing once again.
Sure you are.
I'd like to see
sometime
that.
Sometime in April.
Shall we
I
go?
I sang one evening there.
Yes, right.
I resigned by popular demand.
As a director, may I make a suggestion?
Yes.
Don't close with the mule train thing.
What about Zorro? How is that grab you?
Or that or either one.
Terrific.
I'd try
Next
something
time
more light.
We get together on this very stage, you will see these very bodies.
Gary Crosby, Red Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Fanny Flagg.
See you later here. Join us next time in Match Game 78. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 78, a Mark Goodson, Bill Trotman production.